The HVAC industry has come a long way since its first system was put out on the market. A big part of that evolution has been the technology used to push the air into our homes. Today we're talking about three types of motors. We're going to talk about their operation and their uses in today's residential HVAC systems. We've had standard PSC motors that are found in the majority of homes today. And I'd say 80% of the systems that we work on today have PSC motors. They're the ones that have the capacitors strapped to them to help them start the motor and help it run efficiently. And I'll explain a little bit more about that in a second. Next is the constant torque motor. One that we use often is the Gentech X13 motor. That motor is a high efficiency motor that helped manufacturers meet the 13-SEER mandate implemented by the federal government in 2006. To be clear, X13 is the Gentech brand name. Other brands offer similar motors. However, for the purpose of this video, the term constant torque motor will be used to describe all of those motors. A constant torque motor is not a variable speed motor, but both of them are ECM, or electronically commutated motors. Variable speed motors in HVAC systems are the premium option in today's systems. They allow systems to run from a very low speed up to 100% of their capacity. Being able to dial in the desired speed precisely makes them the motors that are best choice for all types of advanced systems. And just as a side note for folks who live here in Sacramento County who might be looking for rebates available through our local utility company, SMUD has verbiage in their new rebate structure, and this is in 2021, so double check those rebates, that the new rebates revolve around furnaces and air handlers that have variable speed motors. In this case, ECM variable and ECM constant torque motors are the same to SMUD. But in the real world, when we're talking to each other about these two different motors, it's constant torque and variable speed motors. So let's expand a little bit now on the differences between those three motors. PSC motors. Ever heard of Nikola Tesla? I'm sure you have. He's the inventor of the first practical design of the split phase induction motor. He made them easy to use, low cost, and compact in design so well that the industrial market started using them more and more. They got to be so useful, home appliances started using them in a variety of ways, like heating and cooling. While simple to build and low in cost, they are being drowned out by today's modern high efficiency motors. Three or four high voltage wires control the speed of the motor. They're pretty simple to switch out. They're usually like a high, a medium high, medium low, and low tap attached to these blower motors. When that winding receives 120 volts from the furnace's control board, it starts up at that speed. But 120 volts isn't the only thing that's needed to start that PSC motor. It needs a capacitor to provide the energy to get that motor up and running. The capacitor winding stays in the circuit the entire time that the motor runs, which is where we get the P in PSC for permanent. The S in PSC stands for split because it's a motor that uses single phase AC, which has been split by the utility into two equal proportions, just in opposite polarities. And then C is for capacitor, which, as we already know, is the storage bucket of energy that the motor consumes to start and run efficiently. The reason PSC motors are getting phased out is that they build up heat, which decreases the motor's efficiency. This earned them a rating of 60% efficiency. But hey, that's been the standard in residential heating and cooling for a long time. If there are restrictions in airflow, like undersized ductwork, dirty filters, or dirty evaporator coils, PSC motors start to lose performance. They deliver less air because they tend to bog down, drawing higher amperage. The system's static pressure, or blood pressure of the system, builds up and fights back against the PSC motor, wearing it and the capacitor down through overheating. PSC motors aren't the quietest motors either. In fact, of the three motors that we're discussing today, the PSC motor is the noisiest. Having said that, PSC motors are the least expensive to buy and repair. The next two types of motors are much pricier to repair or replace. ECM constant torque motors. Probably the most familiar name in ECM constant torque motors is the X13 motor by Gentech. Gentech acquired General Electric's motors and capacitors division in 2004, and in 2009 renamed themselves Gentech. I bring this up because the first high-efficiency residential HVAC ECM motors were made by GE back in the 1980s. Even though they're like upgraded PSC motors, they're a little bit more complicated in design because they use an integrated control board to send the signal for operation and at what speed or torque setting to run at. Because of this, they're more expensive. Not quite as expensive as variable speed motors, but significantly higher than PSC motors. X13 motors were designed in 2006 to achieve higher SEER ratings for the air conditioners being put into homes. The government set the standard, so the industry has to keep up. The SEER rating that they were trying to achieve at that time was 13, thus the name X13 motor. So what does constant torque motor mean? As the system gets dirty or ductwork is too small, maybe the filter hasn't been changed in a year, the system's static pressure or blood pressure will increase because it's becoming restricted. So just like the PSC motor, it'll start to decrease in the amount of air that it can push out, but not quite as drastic as the PSC motor, as much as 20% less impact on a semi-restricted system. When the airflow decreases on air conditioning mode, the system can freeze up with ice and completely restrict airflow. While in heating mode, low airflow means that the system can overheat and shut down, wait for itself to cool off, start back up, overheat, shut back down, and over until it completely locks itself out. So with a constant torque motor, the chance of the system shutting down because of airflow restriction is less because the drop in airflow produced isn't as drastic as with the PSC motor. If you decrease the amount of air that a PSC motor moves because of dirty ductwork, dirty filter, or dirty system, it'll use less power and not deliver the same amount of air as if it were clean. It's not a smart motor. In the same situation, a constant torque motor will increase its power output to the shaft, which spins the wheel harder to try and maintain more airflow through the duct system, preventing those issues that we were just talking about. And there are safeties programmed into the motor to prevent it from destroying itself if airflow gets really bad. So the power block to the constant torque motor receives a high voltage and a low voltage signal. The upper portion of the block has connections for the high, and the lower terminals are for the low voltage taps. So instead of having high voltage determine the speed like on the PSC motor, low voltage taps are plugged into either the 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5 terminals, which have been pre-programmed to a specific torque setting by the manufacturer. And only some of those taps may have been pre-programmed, so maybe only the 1, 2, and 3 terminals work on the low voltage side because the maker of the air handler decided it to be that way. A constant torque motor is a brushless motor, which reduces heat within the rotor and stator area. They're 80% efficient compared to the PSC motors, which are rated at 60% efficient. They also don't need a capacitor to start and run. They have integrated electronics built into the motor, which means if either the motor windings or the circuitry goes bad, the whole motor has to be replaced. Okay, ECM variable speed motors. GE, which I said before, was acquired by Gentech on the motor side, introduced the first variable speed motors for use in its HVAC systems in 1987. So it's not a new technology. So, you know how when you get in your car on a 100 degree day and set the AC with that auto button to reach 70 degrees? Well, when the car first starts up, the AC fan turns on about as high as it can to match the cooling effect that the system is trying to produce. Then, as the system starts reaching that 70 degree area, you might notice that the fan starts actually ramping down little by little because the demand isn't as high. Once you reach 70 degrees in the car, the airflow doesn't really stop, does it? No, the air stays on lightly while keeping you at 70 degrees. All the while, you haven't touched any knobs to control that. Do you notice how that motor ramps up and down instead of the constant torque motor and the PSC motors that have set speeds for specific demands from the thermostat? Variable speed motors can fluctuate between very low speeds and high speeds with their brushless design, which helps maintain an impressive 80 to 90% efficiency rating. When airflow in a variable speed system becomes restricted, airflow stays the same, constant airflow, because they've been programmed to know exactly how much torque and airflow that the system needs to function properly. Constant torque motors can only apply a little more power to the blower wheel in an attempt to maintain the airflow needed by the system. The variable speed motor is made of two pieces, the mechanical part, the motor, and the control module. The control module has microprocessors and electronic controls which increase or decrease the speed of the motor. One part or the other can be replaced if needed, so you don't always have to replace the entire motor and module together. And that saves quite a bit of money when it comes time for the repair. But remember that these need to be programmed by the manufacturer, so you can't just buy one on eBay and think it'll work for your specific application. Variable speed systems are not cheap to fix. So it's like, yes, they save money by being more efficient, but they cost an arm and a leg to repair. So who's really coming out ahead? If the shaft is stuck and won't spin, or the windings are out of sort, you can just replace the mechanical portion of it. If the shaft spins freely and ohms out correctly, and the motor's getting proper voltage and communication, then you could have a bad module. It's kind of hard to troubleshoot a module without special tools that can give a proper signal to the motor, in which case, if it didn't respond properly, you'd know that the module was bad. The variable speed motor is powered by high voltage plugged into a power block, just like the ECM constant torque motor. It also receives another signal to the power block, very similar to the constant torque motor. Instead of the individual taps with 24 volts being applied to it, variable speed motors have a multi-pin communication connector. Previous versions of these variable speed motors have used AC signals, DC signals, and in today's motors, serial communication. Another reason why technicians need those special devices to troubleshoot them. So in conclusion, PSC motors are simple, fairly inexpensive, moderately efficient motors with a reputation for being loud and not very dynamic. They also come hitched with the always unpredictable capacitor, which can go out due to overheating. ECM constant torque and ECM variable speed motors are pretty complex in design, high efficiency motors known for being much quieter on startup and shutdown. Their ability to control airflow better than PSC motors makes them smart motors because they can ramp up power as needed. The variable speed more so than the constant torque motor. All of this comes with a higher price tag though when it comes to repairs. The practical side of me asks, so the ECM motors are more efficient, saving money on operation of a low amperage blower motor by 20%. But when it comes to repairs, I'm going to have to pay thousands for a technician to install a new motor? And this is the world we live in. If this is your first time watching our channel, please click subscribe down here on the bottom right. And if you click that little bell next to it, you'll be notified of all of our videos as they come out. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you on the next video.
You're watching Fox Family Heating and Air. Don't forget to subscribe. And check out more of our videos by clicking on the right side of the screen.